This is an NFC Pro tutorial from Seritag, looking at how NFC tag scan distances vary between tags and between phones. Scan distance is simply how close you need to place your phone to the NFC tag before you get a response. It's important to quickly understand the basics. All NFC tags, whether they are key fobs, stickers, disc tags or cards, will contain three key elements: a tiny microchip, an antenna, which is just a coil of wire, and something to hold it together. As there are no battery or power source, an NFC chip must get all of its power from an active device, such as a mobile phone. Let's start by having a quick look at what factors affect how easily and effectively the NFC chip can get that power. First, the size of the antenna in the NFC tag. In reality, this is more to do with the length of the antenna than the actual physical size or diameter of the antenna. Simply, the larger the antenna, the easier it is for the NFC tag to power up, and therefore the further away the phone needs to be. Second, the microchip. The chip itself can have a bearing on the typical scan distance, but also the potential scan distance of the tag. Simply put, some microchips need more power to work than others. If it needs more power, then the phone will need to be closer to provide that power. Third, the antenna tuning. Again, without getting too technical, the NFC tags need to be tuned to a specific frequency of 13.56 MHz to work best. If that tuning is off because the tag isn't made very well or has been affected by other materials around it, then the performance can drop significantly. A well-made reel of tags will have consistent tuning and therefore consistent performance. Fourth, antenna design. This is partly the actual shape and design of the antenna itself, but also involves antenna matching, which is how well the antenna design of the tag works with the antenna design in the phone. This can get very complicated very quickly, so we'll move on. Fifth is the power output of the phone itself. If the phone is capable of providing more power, then the phone can be further from the tag. However, normally this doesn't affect which tag you should use, unless you're choosing a tag for a specific phone, which is unusual. Sixth is whether the tag is a normal NFC tag or an on-metal NFC tag. NFC tags designed for metal surfaces always perform worse in terms of scan distance than normal tags. We'll discuss the reasons why in another video, but for the best scan distance, always avoid on-metal tags. General scan distances of NFC tags typically vary from around 1 cm to 5 cm. Some very small tags might have a scan distance with some phones of just a few millimeters. Some larger tags with the right phone might achieve 7 or 8 cm without problem. Let's do some testing. We are going to look at two NFC labels. Both of these tags have an NTAG 213 microchip. First is a small 12 mm by 19 mm tag, which is generally as small as you would want to go with a label. The second is a very common 29 mm size label. We will be using an iPhone XS and a Samsung Galaxy S10. The hotspot on the S10 is around the middle of the back. The hotspot on the iPhone is near the top edge and will be scanning the tags from within an app. First, we'll test the 12 mm by 19 mm with the Samsung S10. Second, we'll test the same tag with the iPhone XS. Now, we'll change to the 29 mm tag with the Android phone. Finally, we'll use the same 29 mm tag with the iPhone. As you can see, a small increase in the size of the NFC tag can make a significant difference to the scan distance. For more information and advice, please visit seritag.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.